guys, Jeff the Nature Guy on a beautiful day. And look where I'm at, the Yellowstone River. It doesn't get much better than this. Longest undammed river in the United States, and boy, are we just fortunate that it's right in our backyard here in Montana. But I'm here because, as you can probably imagine, I love to explore the river. I love to explore under rocks, see what I can find. I always have loved that, and I always will love that. And when you flip over rocks in the river system, you're gonna find some pretty amazing things. And I wanna talk about something that you see a lot of times when you flip over these rocks, and that's these guys right here, those weird looking, kind of vicious looking insects, bugs, macro invertebrates, whatever you want to call them. But the funny thing is, these guys are relatively harmless. They're not going to bother you. And what you're looking at right here, this particular one, is actually not alive anymore. It's just the exoskeleton, which means, just like you remember I've talked about cicadas or locusts, they crawl out of that little exoskeleton, and then the insect that they become is obviously what comes out of that. So this one here obviously latched onto this. They live in the river system for a couple months, and then they emerge out of this exoskeleton and turn into this. And what in the world is this? It's called a stonefly. And look at this thing, it's so cool. They love to eat, live by the riverside and eat small other bugs and anything else, small little organic matter that might go through the river. These guys, as big as they look and as vicious as they look, again, harmless, and they're very terrible flyers. Even though they have those incredibly large wings, they just don't fly very well, which is too bad. But nonetheless, they have found a great, of course, habitat along the riverside here. Now get this, the female stonefly can lay anywhere up to 6,000 eggs at one time. She just drops them in the river system. They, of course, attach to rocks, and then this nymph, which is this thing here, is essentially what is born, and then this guy pupates out of that nymph there. And again, what a cool little critter. The best thing about stoneflies, we just don't really give them much thought, but they are so important to you and I because they are a great indicator species to when something's going wrong in our river system. So a lot like frogs. Frogs, of course, breathe through their skin. We know there's an environmental catastrophe when frogs start dying out. Something's going on. These guys aren't much different. If something's going on in this river, there's a pollution or something of that sort, and we start seeing mass die-offs of these mayflies, these stoneflies, that's a pretty big deal. But anyway, guys, get out to the river. There are some amazing discoveries awaiting you out here. But fair warning, when you come out here, make sure you got mom and dad with you, because the currents in this river system can be pretty darn dangerous, and you just don't want to be out there swimming. You want to make sure you stay by the shore, have mom and dad close. But anyway, there are some great discoveries waiting for you when you come out here to the river. Guys, until next time, I am Jeff the Nature Guy with my stonefly buddy here. We'll see you at the zoo.